to Ayresome Park Middlesbrough now for a league match in March 1989. This promising young Middlesbrough side had been promoted the previous year. But look at the Liverpool side, a host of internationals on show, and the 1987-88 champions were in resurgent form. Martin Tyler is the commentator.
Liverpool kick off, sporting their away strip of silver grey. Middlesbrough are sporting suntans because they've been away in Bermuda for a break. There was no league game for them a week ago because of the international preparations, and they feel that's just the tonic that they need to take on the champions, with Liverpool looking to make a late charge here over the last third of the season to try and retain their title. Brennan takes the game's first free kick, and it's a goal kick. That's a strange one from Cooper, and it's an unnecessarily conceded corner. Colin Cooper scurrying to get back in position. It was Beardsley who took the corner quickly. Barnes just lifting it in, and Pears keeping his eye on the ball, and there was nothing too menacing about a Liverpool player coming in to challenge him. Parkinson, and Barnes has won it away from Pallister. Aldridge up with him. Barnes goes the direct route. Hit it straight, but not very hard. At this stage last season, Liverpool had won 19 and drawn the other 5 of their 24 games. Looking threatening with Beardsley, and he's threaded it in. After 19 minutes, Peter Beardsley suddenly found himself away through the centre. Pears came out, but the shot was very well angled just inside that far post. So Beardsley regaining some of his sharpness when it comes to tucking the ball away in front of goal. He's had such a barren run, a run that's really cost him his starting place in the England side. He was only used as a substitute again in Albania. But back in his native northeast here, he's turned the game for the moment Liverpool's way. It's only his 6th of the season. He's now scored in the last 2 games for Liverpool. Slaven, it was not dissimilar in terms of pace of the shot, but Grobbelaar just got something to it. And Middlesbrough had the corner, earned for them by Bernie Slaven, their top scorer. Well, the height of Mowbray might be a factor here. Pallister coming in deeper, but the corner was wasted by Hamilton. McMahon. Liverpool really on their mettle. They've had some unusual lapses away from home in recent league games. 3 goals conceded at Manchester United, 2 at Sheffield Wednesday, 2 at Newcastle. They've got a goal to bite on here. Barnes. Obstructed by Mowbray, no doubt about that. Beasley looking very, very alive. And all Kerr can do is give Liverpool a corner. But at the moment, Peter Beardsley is really sparking Liverpool. Not just with the lead that he's given to them, but with the all-round brightness of his play. We're halfway through the first half at this Liverpool corner. Gillespie jumped in there, but I don't think he got the final touch. And off Gary Pallister for another Liverpool corner. Well, again, Gillespie came in, and that time he did meet it, but directed it wide. Was a great compliment to Gary Gillespie that Scotland called him up. He'd played 10 minutes of an FA Cup tie against Hull and one league game against Charlton for Liverpool since October. But Andy Roxburgh believed in his quality. A reminder that Liverpool are through to the quarterfinals of the FA Cup, and they've got what looks on paper a straightforward home tie against Brentford of the third division. Difficult to place the ball on this windy afternoon, and difficult looking into the sun as well. Parkinson takes the free kick. Came off Gillespie, and that was scrambled away by Ablett. Now Middlesbrough need a better corner this time. A change from Hamilton to Brennan to take it. Swung away from goal, Pallister! Defending difficult in these conditions when the ball is hung up high. Pallister timed his approach well. Now was caught after the ball had gone by Brennan. Ray Houghton played for the Republic of Ireland in Hungary on Wednesday, as did John Aldridge as well as Ronnie Whelan. Whelan reinstalled as the Liverpool captain after missing the last two games with suspension. Incidentally, the first time Ronnie Whelan has ever been suspended. Oh, the linesman flagging. And Liverpool dropped off very quickly the moment the ball was kicked. Barnes. Beardsley read the bounce better than Pallister. Help is there from Staunton and from Barnes. Houghton have made a terrific run from right to left. Barnes used McMahon. Beardsley carrying and harassing tactics from Middlesbrough, but they can't get the ball. Whelan scuffs an attempted shot. McMahon does rather better. That couldn't have been too far away. Steve McMahon still looking for his first league goal of the season, which is quite remarkable when you think he got 9 last season in the first division. Some of them in that style. Ripley. Mowbray. Whelan intercepting well in that holding role in the centre of Liverpool's midfield. Doesn't get forward as often as perhaps he used to do, Ronnie Whelan. Tends to lead that to McMahon. Bartlett. And now Staunton. Parkinson not making it easy for Cooper, but he came through that little test well. Hamilton on for Davenport. Now Slaven. Kerr in the centre. Ripley's there as well. It was the head of Gillespie. And a very good header too that dealt with the danger. Aldridge cushioning the pass for Whelan. And here come Liverpool again with Beardsley. Barnes to the left. Liverpool can feed John Barnes. You know that they're maintaining a measure of superiority in midfield, although Barnes couldn't make too much of the service that time. Ripley. This is more like it for Middlesbrough, but he was running into a very congested area with his head down. Houghton. It's an interesting pass and a very good one too. Beardsley taking on Mowbray. He slipped him. Beardsley! It's 2-0, followed in by Ray Houghton. ...36 minutes gone. Liverpool's superiority being confirmed here at this stage of the game. Beardsley having scored the first, setting up the second for Houghton. Slipping Mowbray, hit hard and low across. And Cooper and Houghton going for it together. McMahon. We're into stoppage time at the end of the first half. Maybe time for Middlesbrough to make something from this free kick. They badly need to do so. Liverpool have pulled everyone back, recognising the importance of coming through unscathed here. Well, there are four Middlesbrough players addressing the ball. It's Hamilton who smacks at it, but puts it wide. And really, considering that Middlesbrough have had the wind at their backs, they haven't produced the sort of shots downwind to trouble Grobbelaar. Barnes beaten by the bounce. Remember, Middlesbrough going into this game with a very good home record. That's to be recalled when you evaluate Liverpool's first half performance, which has been full of authority. Barnes. Although Liverpool have had to play into a blustery wind, they've offered a classy first 45 minutes here, embroidered by goals from Peter Beardsley, and Beardsley setting up the second for Ray Houghton. Middlesbrough with a great deal to do in the second half at Ayresome Park. At half-time, it's Middlesbrough 0, Liverpool 2.
The iPhone has all kinds of apps. There are apps for reading the news. There are apps for reading a comic. Apps for heading outdoors. And apps for staying indoors. There are apps for finding a hotel or just finding your car. Yep, there's an app for just about anything, only on the iPhone.
We're just going out, Mum.
Have a nice time.
Do you want some help, Mrs. Harris?
No, it's all right, lad. I've got it covered.
You've gone all green since we got that heating bill, haven't you, Dad?
Might as well have chucked money away in that roof.
If you'd insulated the roof properly in the first place, we wouldn't even be having this conversation.
All right, don't shoot the drummer, boy. I'm just one man. Just one man trying to make a difference. Because I love this world.
Most UK homes don't have the recommended amount of loft insulation. Insulating properly can reduce CO2 emissions and save money on heating bills. Find out more. Search online for Act on CO2. Save money, save energy.
The expert shopper is ready for anything that comes her way, especially a bargain. 3 for 2 on vitamins and herbal products at Boots. Boots. Value you can feel good about.
Sky Poker is the poker site for players of every level, where you play in pounds, not dollars. Play instantly without downloading. Play even better with game analysis on Sky Poker TV and hand reviews live on air. And you're guaranteed to win between £1 and £150 in our free welcome draw, with no deposit necessary, all from a name you can trust. So whatever your level, play without downloading, get live TV analysis and win between £1 and £150 in our free welcome draw. Join now, only at skypoker.com.
There's a great deal going on in Yorkshire, and you can find all the great offers and magnificent attractions at yorkshire.com.
Darling.
Yeah?
I've got something to tell you.
Mm.
I'm pregnant.
That's fantastic.
They think it's twins.
Cushion yourself with an ING Direct savings account. ING Direct. Saving feels good.
Well, Middlesbrough fired up from the dressing room, I'm sure, to address their problems quickly in the second half. And if they could snatch a goal quickly, I just wonder as the match goes on whether the efforts of those World Cup wanderings from the Liverpool international stars in midweek might sap them in the later stages. Perhaps Bruce Rioch will be hoping that will happen. But his team really need to show more firepower. Slaven. Hamilton coming in, but that's Grobbelaar's. Really haven't functioned at all as an attacking force. They've been given a lesson in that respect by the class of Beardsley in particular, and the way Liverpool in general have operated as a unit. And indeed in their ruthless finishing. Davenport. No way forward this time. Peter Davenport's only scored twice in 18 appearances for Middlesbrough since his move from Manchester United. One of those was the winner, though, against his old club. That was almost a pass to open Liverpool up from Davenport. Cooper. Middlesbrough too anxious now. Really settling on the ball when they are in possession. And that's making Liverpool's job of defending that much easier. Nicol. Gillespie drops for McMahon. Kerr chasing in, but McMahon seemed to be in control of the situation until it came to playing the ball back. Whether Kerr just tapped the ankles or whether McMahon simply miscued, only he knows. It's the second time this half that Liverpool have conceded an unnecessary corner. Really hung up for Mowbray to fight for, and he's contributed some useful goals in recent seasons. And that really would have been very sloppy by Liverpool's standards if the mishit back pass had led to a goal from the resulting corner. It's not a common problem of an English winter, but this has been an exceptional one. The sun has shone, the temperatures have been mild, the football has gone on without any real interruption to the schedules. And Liverpool are going on here like the Liverpool of old. It hasn't always been that way this season. They've got 13 league games left after this one. With Liverpool, they're quite capable of winning the lot. And what they do have over the run-in, of course, is plenty of experience of the pressures of chasing a championship. But here's Ripley, trying to change the picture here. Grobbelaar with one of those one-handed efforts. Not quite the best he's ever done. He dropped on the ball, though. Once it had rolled from the grasp. Here's Beardsley! And that would have ended any doubts. And the chasing work of Aldridge and then the loss of bearings by Mowbray were factors there. Well, that break in Bermuda hasn't really been too much of a tonic for Middlesbrough in this match so far. You think Liverpool have been away on holiday, the way they're revelling in their task, putting the passes together again. And Houghton, the goalkeeper's hesitated, and Houghton could have done better. Again, it wasn't an easy ball to hit running away from him. Bobbling on a firm pitch. But Pears was uncertain in his positional work. And had Houghton connected cleanly, he could well have made it 3-0. McMahon. Taken from him by Kerr. There haven't been many victories in midfield in the tussles for Middlesbrough. It's been a rock-like performance in that quarter from Liverpool. But really, the extra edge has come further forward from Beardsley. Nicol! Oh, my word, it nearly went in. Houghton and Pears finally gets a grasp on it. A touch of inspiration from Nicol in trying the shot to catch out the goalkeeper. He certainly did that. Hamilton. Nicol back defending. Brennan. Slaven. This is Parkinson. Middlesbrough do have a lot of players forward. But it's Liverpool's throw. Well, Steve Pears from Steve Nicol was in great difficulties. An instant shot from Nicol with the wind at his back, and how Middlesbrough should have done more of that in the first half. And it was touched onto the post by Pears after the fumble, and then he clutched it from Houghton. Just seems to be no way through for them. You can't say the same though about Liverpool, who have been carving out chances at will. And this is one for Aldridge that he has taken just. So he extends this remarkable run, scoring in a seventh consecutive game for Liverpool. It looked as though he had too much time, as Whelan played him through superbly. Pears held him up, blocked it the first time, and off the post, and in fact in off Parkinson in the end. Gillespie with the header. 6 minutes left. And coming at a time when some of the clubs above Liverpool in the table haven't been playing their best football of the season. This really is an indication that Liverpool still believe that they have a say in what's going to happen come the end of the season. And Kenny Dalglish has that hunger for success that characterises Liverpool. Whelan deflected off Pallister for a corner. They're so greedy at Liverpool for honours. It's meant as a compliment, put like that. And they're still greedy for goals here. 3-0 up away from home. McMahon. Past Hamilton, ahead of Cooper in the way. McMahon. Kerr showing too much of the ball to Whelan, but prepared to scrap for it. He's earned his money, Paul Kerr. Ripley. Ablett playing the ball with the shoulder. Ripley. Oh, and Gillespie decided not to go for it, inviting Grobbelaar to make the move. He was just a little late to accept the invitation, but he arrived in time. Nasty ball in for the goalkeeper to deal with. Bruce Grobbelaar hasn't been on a losing Liverpool side this season. It's only his 12th game. Remember, he was out with meningitis and then couldn't get his place back through the excellent form of his deputy, Mike Hooper. And he's really become a talisman for the team. Beardsley. Aldridge is onside, he's got a long way to go, and he needs to take the ball with him. Here's Houghton for Aldridge, and it was a little over elaborate in the end. been altogether a very satisfying afternoon for Liverpool and a miserable one for Middlesbrough. And still Liverpool aren't satisfied. Pallister, that might well be a foul by Beardsley. But more than any one player, Peter Beardsley set the tone for Liverpool in the first half, and his teammates were very quick to follow the example. Barnes. Aldridge reversed it beautifully for Steve McMahon. 4-0. It's becoming something of a rout. It doesn't flatter Liverpool. They're worth the margin by which they lead. And who says that Aldridge is just a goal scorer? That was a terrific ball through. And McMahon bided his time and then planted it past Pears. So McMahon does get his first division goal of the season. And he's had to wait 11 months since his last goal in the league. 4 in total this season, the other 3, of course, in cups. Been a gap in class from the moment that Beardsley put Liverpool in front. It deflated Middlesbrough. From Pallister. Houghton. Well, Liverpool were always a problem for Bruce Rioch when he used to play against them in the first division. The likes of Derby and Everton. And as a manager, that expression really told the story of his afternoon. Cooper. Davenport. And still, Liverpool don't slacken their grip. Barnes. It's all over. A thumping victory for Liverpool, really inspired at the outset by Peter Beardsley. He set up the second for Ray Houghton. John Aldridge came away claiming the third, although the final touch went in off the defender Gary Parkinson, and Steve McMahon wrapped it up with number 4 right at the end. A final score at Ayresome Park: Middlesbrough 0, Liverpool 4.